Okay, so what we saw yesterday was we saw how is binding done. That is, we have few data members and we display the values of those data members in our UI, that is in front end, that is in HTML. So how is that binding done? That binding is done using two curly braces, and inside that you give the data member and it binds, right? So I'll delete all this. Okay, along with that, what we also saw was we saw ng4. Now what is ng4? ng4 is a directive which is used to iterate over an array, right? That array should be a data member, right? That is what we use ng4 for, and so that we can iterate and display that element in HTML. What is ngif? ngif is conditional display of an element, right? So if the condition is true, that element would be displayed, otherwise that element will not be displayed. That is what is ngif, and this is what we saw. So today what we are going to study or look at is writing member functions inside our class. That is what we are going to study. So what I'll do is I'll remove everything, right? I'll remove everything from HTML as well, right? And just see that my page is blank. Yes, I'll have one simple h1 tag, and inside h1 I'll just bind some, say, title, first project. Right, so what I am seeing is first project. Okay, now what I'll do is I'll have a button, right? And I'll just type some name and I'll say click me, right? So we can see a button. If I click, nothing is happening here, right? Now one important thing to note, right, which is very very important whenever you are doing UI programming, is to open the console. How to do that? We right click and we click on inspect. Once we do that, we click on console, right? That's what we have here. And here in this console, right, we'll be able to see whatever we log onto the console, right? I'll tell you how we can log, right? Next, what we need to do is on the click of this button, what I want is, I want some action to be taken. On the click of this button, I want some action to be taken. Now, that action can be done using some member function. So what I'll do is, I'll create a member function. I'll call it as, say, fun. Right, and in this, I'm simply saying console.log in fun. That's what I am saying here, right? So what I am doing here, in my app.component.ts file, in my app component class, I am having a member function called as fun. This member function does not have any parameter, and inside this member function I am simply saying console.logfun. Now if this function gets executed, what is going to happen is, in this console you will be able to see this message, which is in fun. That is what this console is for, right? And it is very important that we know how to, or we keep on logging, so that we understand the flow. Because front-end development or UI development, it is all event-driven. Now, what do we mean by event-driven? That because some event occurs, or because some action, or because some say action takes place, right, on the basis of that we need something to happen, right? It's not straightforward line by line kind of programming, right? This is all event based programming, right? So what we have done here is, in my app component class I have simply created a function fun, right? It is simple member function of this class, and it only has a console.log statement which says in fun. That's it. Right, so whenever this fun would be executed, what would happen is, in fun would be logged in this console, or it will be printed in this console. Right, now how to execute this function? Right, if I click on this, again nothing is happening. Now what we need to do is, we need to tell this button that, okay boss, whenever you are clicked, this is what you need to do, or this is the function that needs to be called. So what I'll do is, in my button, in my element button, right, I'll have an event, which is click event. So whenever this button is clicked, I'll call the function fun. So what is happening here is that whenever the button is clicked, I'll call the function fun. Let's check that out now. Now what is going to happen if I click this button? If I click this button, this fun should be called. Right? And whenever the fun is called, what is going to happen? It will print in fun. And where will it print? It will print it in the log. Right? So if I click it here, it prints in fun. If I click it again, it prints in fun. See, 2 is getting here. If I click it again, 3, 4, 5, likewise. So what it means is that on the click, whenever the button is clicked, what I am doing is I am calling a function fun. Whenever the button is clicked, I am calling the function fun. This is what is happening here. Right, now next is that I'll have another button. Right, and I would give it name change title. I'll give it a name change title. Right, so I have a title which says first project here. I have a title which says first project here. Right, so I'll have a function, I'll call it say change title. And in this, what I would say this dot title equals to my new title. What I am saying is this dot title equals to my new title. Now what is this title? This title is nothing but the data member which you have in this class app component. So whenever you have to access the data member within some other function in the same class, you need to use this, right? It is mandatory. So if I have to access this title, I have to access it using the this pointer. So I say this dot title equals to my new title, right? This is used to access the data member or the member of your class. Now what I would do is, on the click of this button, again, before that, let us check if anything is happening. If I say, if I click on change title, nothing is happening as of now. If I click on click me, you can get in fun. Why is nothing happening when I click on change title? Because we have not assigned any action to it. So what I'll do is I'll say on click, I would simply say change title. So I am calling this function. What is that function? This function is change title. Now what is happening here is, right, we need to understand. We have a title which is a data member here, and this title, it has the value first project, and we are binding this first project here. So that is the reason this h1 tag, it shows first project. Why? Because the value of this title, it is coming in this first project. Right, and that is being shown in your UI. Now if I click on change title, what should happen is this should change to my new title. Why? Because I am changing the value of this data member title. Let's check that out. If I click on change title, it says my new title. Right, now if I click it again, nothing is happening. Why is nothing happening? Does it mean that the function is not called again? No, it does not mean that, but nothing is happening because the value of the string title, it is still my new title, so nothing is going to change, right? There is no change in this. Now to check whether my function is called or not, what I'll do is I'll call this function inside this change title function. How will I call it? I'll say this dot fun. Now what is going to happen is, every time I click on this button change title, right, first time it will change this to my new title, right, and it will click infun. Every time it will start clicking, it will print click infun. Let's check that out. So I click on change title, it changed this, and here it printed infun. I again do this, it is again printing infun. Again printing infun, again printing infun, but it is not changing the title. Right, why? Because the value of title is the same. So even though it is assigning the value, still nothing would be visible in the UI. Right, so let's say that if we have to modify it or toggle it. By toggle, what I mean is that the first value should be, whatever is the first value, it should come back again. So I would say, if this dot title equals to first project, then this dot title equals to my new title. Else, I would say this dot title equals to first project. I'll remove this function call from here. Now what is going to happen is that if the value of title is first project, which will always be there for the first time, it will change the value of title to my new title, right? And next time if we click, right, this condition would be false and it will change its value to first project. Now this would be the, this will give us the toggling effect. Let's check that out. I click on change title, it changes to my new title. I click again, I get first project. Right, so this is what is toggling. This is what is happening here. So what I am doing here, right, or what we have learned is, we have a button, right, and we have written a few member functions inside our class. That's what we have done. Then on the click of that button, right, we are calling some member function. And inside that member function, you can do whatever you want, right? It is simple, basic phenomenon. What I am doing here is, I am simply changing the value of a data member title. And because that title we have, say, coupled it with in our UI, or we have used double curly braces, right? It gets bind, and what we see is its value here. That is what we see. Right, so it is a very, very simple exercise which helps us in on assigning some action to your button. That is what it does. Now this click handler or this click action, right, it is not necessary that it will happen only on a button, right? You can have it on other elements as well. Let's say if I have a click here, and here I'll say change title. Now let's see what happens. Change title is not a function. Okay. Yeah. Now if I click on this title, it is changing itself. Right, so it is not this, what is this click? This click is an event. It is an event, right? So whenever there is a click on this H1 tag, especially this one, this title one's tag, right, it is going to call this change title event. Right, so you can have your magic here. Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay, great, great. Right, now what I'll do is, I'll have another H1, right, which again would be calling change title, right, again no rocket science. Then I'll have another data member and I'll call it, let's say, flag, and I'll say false. And in the change title function, I'll simply say flag equals to not of flag. Sorry, this dot flag equals to not of flag. What it means is, if this flag is true, it will become false, and if it is false, it will become true. And what I'll do is, I'll have star ngif equals to, I'll use flag here, means if this flag is true, this element would be shown, and I'll say star ngif equals to, I'll say not of flag here, means if the flag is false, this element would be shown. Next, what I'm going to do is, I'll create some class, say dot c1, and in this I'll give background color, I can say brown, and text color I'll use as, say, white, right? I'm just giving some random classes. And then I'm creating another class C2. I'll use background color. I'll give, let's say, chocolate. And color, I'll use, say, black. I'm just giving random colors, right? And in my H1 tag, what I'll do is, I'll say class equals to C1, and here I'll give class equals to C2. Now let's see what happens. Can you see the change? Right, so I'm just reiterating what I've done. What I've done is, right, I have two elements, both the elements are showing title. वो bind करके हमने title दिखाया है, right? On clicking both the elements, what is happening is the title is getting changed, right? But only one element would be displayed at a time. Why? Because we have used this ngif directive. And what does ngif do? It will show the first element if this flag is true, and it will show the second element if the flag is false. For the first element, I have a different styling. For the second element, I have different styling. Right? There are other ways of using this as well, but as of now, we'll display it in this way. Right? So, if you see it like this, even if I click on change title, still it would change. Right, so ये समझ में आया है क्या किया है और कैसे किया है? ठीक है, great, right? Now what we'll do is, these two things can be done एक ही जगह पे कर सकते हैं, right? So what I will do is, I'll remove this ngif here, and instead I'll use ng class, right? अभी ng class क्या करता है, कौन सा class assign करना है वो बताता है. तो we'll say if flag equals to true, I'll use the class c1, else I'll use the class c2. Let's see if this works and if it is syntactically correct. Yes, it does. So what is happening here is, यहाँ मैंने क्या यूज़ किया है, मैंने एक ng क्लास यूज़ किया है, ng क्लास, राइट। तो ng क्लास क्या करता है, ये भी एक डायरेक्टिव है, जैसा ng for और ng if है वैसा ही ng क्लास एक डायरेक्टिव है। तो ng क्लास क्या करता है कि वो कौन सा क्लास यूज़ करना है ये बताता है, राइट। तो दिस इज एक सिंपल टर्शरी ऑपरेटर जो हम लोग यूज़ करते हैं, राइट। सो वॉट इट डज इज, इट सेज दैट इफ फ्लैग इज ट्रू, इफ दिस कंडीशन इज ट्रू, तो C1 दिखाओ या तो फिर C2 दिखाओ, राइट। यानी C1 क्लास यूज करो, अदरवाइज C2 क्लास यूज करो, राइट। सो यू नीड टू चेक दीज थिंग्स आउट, ये ng क्लास क्या है, इसको यूज करने का तरीका देखो। मैंने कैसे यूज किया है, स्क्वायर ब्रैकेट्स के अंदर आई हैव यूज्ड ng क्लास एंड C इज कैपिटल इन दिस, राइट। सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द वैल्यू ऑफ द फ्लैग द करस्पॉन्डिंग क्लासेस वुड बी यूज्ड। इज इट क्लियर?